Okay, here we're going to solve this system of equations by graphing. So here we go. For the first one, again, we have to first put in the y is equal to mx plus b form. So let me just work that out right here. 2x plus 6y is equal to 18. I need to isolate the y, so I'll keep this first. That means I will have to minus 2x on both sides. So that this and that will cancel. And then we see that this is 6y, and that's write down equals, and this is minus 2x. Write that down first, and then we have plus 18. And then let's go ahead and divide everybody by 6. Divide this by 6, divide this by 6, and so is that. So cancel, cancel. And that will give us y by itself, and that's equal to negative 2 divided by 6. We get negative 1 over 3. And let me write yes, negative 1. Keep the negative on the top. It's a good idea. And then divide it by 3 and put the x on the side. And here we have the plus 18 over 3 over 6, which is plus 3. So that's the first part, right? So let's go ahead and make the graph first. So this time I will just try my best to do this for you guys, right? So here we go. Let's say we have 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And 1, 2, 3, 4. That should be enough, right? 1, 2, 3, 4. All right. First, we started at the y-intercept, which is the b, which is the 3. That means I go to the y-axis, 1, 2, 3, and here is my first point. And then for the second point, look at the slope. The slope here is negative 1 over 3, meaning that we go down one time from here, and then we move to the right 3 times. So go down one time, and then move to the right 1, 2, 3, and then we put another point right here, right? So that's pretty much the idea. And of course, let's go ahead and connect the dots like this, right? Good. Now, for the second one, let's do that in blue, of course. I set this out already. So here we have the 2x plus 3y equals 6. And again, do the same thing. I will have to minus 2x on both sides, so they cancel. And then we see this is 3y equals negative 2x plus 6. And I will have to divide everybody by 3. Divide this by 3, divide that by 3, divide that by 3. Cancel, cancel. So that we end up with y equals this and that. Cannot reduce, but we'll write it down as negative 2 over 3. And put the x on the side. And 6 over 3, we get positive 2. So we have this. Now, for this one, we are going to start on the y-axis. Here we have the b is equal to 2. So the y-intercept is 2. That means I go up 1, 2 right here on the y-axis. And then I will look at the slope, which is this, m equals, which is negative 2 over 3. This means I will have to go down from here 2 times and then move to the right 3 times. So go down 1, 2 and move to the right 3 times. 1, 2, 3. So it's like this, right? And then, just do this really carefully. You guys have the graph paper on your handout, so you can do this much better than I do. And then use your ruler, use ID cup, whatsoever, right? And I'll tell you, if you connect the dots, you end up with like this. Yeah, I'll try my best, okay? And technically, you actually have a point of intersection right here. And again, let me just try my best. I'll try my best. It's supposed to be like this, right? It's supposed to look like this. And when I give you guys questions that you have to solve by graphing, I will always give you guys whole numbers or some like numbers you can actually tell easily. So here, this point is, you see, negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, and then you go up 1, 2, 3, 4. So this point is actually negative 3, 4, right? Therefore, the answer to this is just, of course, that we have negative 3, 4, and this is it. Thank you.